Hi, I'm Andrea from AWS.
Hi, I'm Syed from Experian, and this is my architecture.
Thanks for being on the show, Syed. What do you guys do at Experian?
Experian is a data analytics and credit scoring company. So we get data from 400,000 plus institutions, financial institutions across the nation. We aggregate the data and provide consumers credit reports and the financial institutions to take decisions on their credit offerings, like loans, auto loans, mortgage, etc.
Wonderful. So earlier we learned that Experian had simplified the machine learning model deployment for clients. So what are we going to talk about today? What business problem are you solving with the architecture that you also run on AWS?
Machine learning model onboarding is just a part of the MLOps platform, right? What comes after that is testing those machine learning models to work fine and training them to make it perfect and deploying them to production and running them in production for batch and real-time use case.
Great, so let's dive straight to it.
Absolutely.
All right, so let's go through the journey. Mm-hmm. Who's the user and how do they initiate a request? Yep.
So we have different sets of users. One of the main users is the data scientist who uses the portal to kick out these batch runs from jobs.
Okay, with that request, mm-hmm. do they have to submit any specific data or files?
When they do it through the portal, that information is just good enough to execute the entire campaign.
Wonderful. Right. And you send it to a managed Kafka?
Correct.
Okay. So walk us through kind of the back end. Uh-huh. I see a lot of other AWS services. So what's the logic?
Yeah. So when the first message is written to the Kafka topic, so it is attached to this consumer. It is the orchestration consumer.
Okay.
They call it the orchestrator, which is on Fargate ECS. Correct. This guy determines the execution plan.
Okay.
Right.
So now you have the execution plan, but what's the set of events that is triggered?
Yes. So once this guy, once the orchestrator determines the execution plan, it writes the message to another topic on MSK, which is managed streaming for Kafka, right?
I see.
Which is consumed by one or more consumers here.
And that sits on Fargate as well?
That is true.
And it listens on a topic you mentioned.
Yes.
Does that mean that you can have multiple of these happening at the same time?
Yes, exactly. So this whole architecture is event-driven, and these four units are, we call it as an operational functional unit, and they are independent, and they can be executed in parallel or as sequential.
So these are, what do you define this? Is it your processing engine?
Yes, it is the processing engine for the batch.
So let's go a little bit deeper here, right? So I see EMR, SageMaker, what are they used for?
Yes, once the execution plan is determined by the orchestrator, and this consumer, which is the operational consumer, will know whether to execute a pre-processing job or any kind of job on a EMR cluster, or it has to trigger a batch transform job on a SageMaker.
I see. Could give us some examples, like why would you use EMR for, for pre-processing?
So when a job is triggered, it could be relying on more than one data source. And these data sources could be in different formats. So we use an EMR cluster to get the data from different sources, make it available in a different format so that it can be easily consumed by the SageMaker.
I see. So transforming the data into SageMaker, what you do. Okay, model. And then in SageMaker, you provide an endpoint. This is the deployment or testing of the model?
Yeah, this architecture could be is used for testing, training, as well as production batch models.
And production.
Yes.
Wonderful. And any given point in time, as a user, say in this case, a data scientist, I want to get an update as to where this is.
Oh, yeah.
How do you facilitate that?
Yeah. So when this consumer triggers the jobs, right? So it also writes the message to Kafka topic so that the next sequential action can be triggered. Right. And not just that, it also writes the message to the open search service, which is our metadata store.
So you can then see kind of the status.
Exactly.
Okay.
So there are APIs which pulls the data from the open search store and relays the current state of job for the users.
What's the function of the event bridge?
Good question. So the entire architecture is event driven, like I said. So when there are jobs, status, state changes happening on the EMR cluster or the SageMaker, they are written or they're actually emitted to EventBridge. We consume that, right? So this consumes a message, and based on the rules, it writes to Actually, it is consumed by another Fargate consumer, okay, which writes the messages to the Kafka topic, which determines the next sequence of actions.
Oh, so you can run many, many different ensembles, pretty
Correct.
Much, right,
yeah.
of these. Okay, wonderful. And I also see another Fargate here.
Oh, yeah. So this is the last consumer, okay, which is actually the notifier. So this consumer or consumers, so can do sequential steps, right? But this consumer is the action consumer or the notifier consumer, which consumes the messages all along and determines if it is the end of the execution of a batch campaign.
Okay.
And when this this consumer determines that it is the end of the execution, so it writes a message to the portal through different mechanisms, or it writes a message to the open source service.
Okay.
So it lets the consumer
notifies the user.
Exactly.
Wonderful. And you're probably running this at scale.
Absolutely.
So what? Tell us a little bit more. Like, at what scale is this?
Yeah. We easily run about like hundreds of batch campaigns, thousands of models and jobs, and billions of consumers, actually tens of billions of consumers every month. And it is easily scalable. That's the whole point of this whole architecture.
That's really impressive. I'll say thanks so much for sharing this story.
Thank you, and absolutely a pleasure to be here.